Hello. Welcome to 7th grade English Language Arts class. I am Kim Dragoo, and I have been teaching for 24 years, ELA. I started out in 5th grade. I've taught 6th, 7th, 8th, and I'm back in 7th grade, and I absolutely love it, and I love your kids. I am a former dyslexia interventionist, and I taught reading and intervention lab for many, many, many years. Before I came back to teaching 7th grade English. I am certified ESL. I am married, and my husband and I have a blended family of 5 children. And so far, we have 2 beautiful grandchildren. I'm an amateur chicken farmer and a colored egg enthusiast, as you can see. I didn't even realize that chickens could lay colored eggs until we started having, till COVID came out, and we just started becoming little chicken farmers. And we have leg bars and olive eggers and marron and just Brahmas, all kinds of chickens that just lay beautiful colored eggs. Just to peek at my classroom, this year I want the kids to really discover who they are. Through reading and writing and creating. I've really enjoyed getting to know your students, and I'm looking forward to getting to know them as authors and as people. And it's just, I'm really excited. They're all currently reading something, and that's always exciting at the beginning of the year. Our ELA learning environment is going to consist of some routines. At the beginning of class, your students are going to come into a warm-up, and they need to complete that just as soon as they can, as soon as they enter the room. And this warm-up will always have something to do with whatever the focus is of our reading and writing workshop that day. These are the components of our, move myself over here a little bit, components of our daily workshop model. We will have a mini lesson. It's about 20% of our 50 minutes. We will have book love or writing response, which is another 20%. Our grammar instruction takes up about 10%. That usually comes in right as we have our warm up. And the majority of our class time will be taken up with readers, writers workshop, which is lots of different things. So our grammar instruction utilizes the patterns of power, and everyday students will come in. They will at first notice something about a sentence, then they will compare one sentence structure to another so that they can see how they're alike and different. They will imitate, which means they take the pattern of the sentence and they create their very own sentence just using the elements of the sentence but their own words. They'll edit and find different sentences with the same pattern. And it's just sort of like this heuristic hands-on way that kids get to understand sentence structure. And their sentences really sound like, published authors. They do such a great job when they're taking a look at the components of an author's sentence and trying to make that their own. Book love is a really big part of our classroom time. Students early on are involved in book talks and shopping for good books. They learn how to use Destiny Discover so they can find whatever it is they like, because that's really my only requirement when it comes to books, is that students need to like them. Each day they have about 10 to 15 minutes to read with no interruption. And those, whatever they read, we are doing a lot of reading in our class of various things, and they may apply strategies for something that we're doing in instruction. They'll apply that to their book love book as well. Our mini lessons are about 20% of the class time, and these are authentic, real-life reading and writing strategies. Then everything that is taught in a mini lesson becomes part of a workshop. everything's research-based. Students will have time in class to apply the strategies we've learned. And when we have process writing, they've got our workshop to go through the different processes on different days. Other important stuff, I'm gonna move me over here, or let me move me up here. Missed work or absences. So when a student is absent from class, they should log on to Schoology and submit assignments that are posted in our folders. If a student is unable to complete assignments for some reason, they need to give me send me a Schoology message so that we can come up with a makeup work plan. If a student is a remote learner, though, they are expected to go ahead and keep up with the work on those days. They'll have their own folder that they'll go into and complete that work and submit it. If a student needs to speak to me at any time about anything, work, or a situation, they just need to email me on Schoology, and I will reply at my earliest opportunity. Grading, we'll have 9 grades for 9 weeks, 9 minor grades, which are 40% of a student's grade. We'll have 3 or more major grades, which are 60% of a student's grade for 9 weeks. Daily supplies, your student will need a composition book, which may need to be supplied after Christmas. They'll have pencils, pens. They need their fully charged Chromebook every single day. They'll need a chapter book for book love and headphones, especially if your student has access to Learning Ally, which is an audiobook service. Some non-essentials, but may be helpful for some students. We do a lot of notebook writing. So if your student wants to bring gel pens or other color pens, those are really helpful. Sticky notes are always great to have, especially with as much reading as we're going to be doing. And also we use them in writing to organize our writing. Homework. You know what, other than the daily reading that kids do, which we get 10 minutes in class and they have about 20 to 30 minutes in Bronco time. So they should be getting, 20, 30 minutes per day at least. Other than that, the only homework your student will have is if there is an assignment in class that they have not finished, or if we're doing some long process writing and they need to finish part of the process at home. So this is my contact information. If you need to get a hold of me, the best way is probably through sending me an email at kim.dragu@bisd.net. My phone number is 254-316-5254, and I'm in room 722. If you need to contact me for a parent conference, or you just need to get a hold of me for some reason, just that's how you do it. And so thank you for joining our virtual open house this evening. Please, please, please don't hesitate to contact me if you have further questions. I'm going to leave with a little slideshow, a photo tribute to your kiddos and some of the books that they are currently reading. And I want to thank you again for sharing your kids with me. I have thoroughly enjoyed the beginning of the school year, some really great personalities, and I'm just really having a great school year this year because of them. And thank you so very much for all that you do at home to support your kids and encourage them to be the best they can be and to keep them reading and writing. Thank you so very much. These photos will be part of our currently reading wall. Every time your child reads a new book, a new photo will be added to the wall as running record of books that he or she has read this year. And we're just going to keep all that reading going. Thank you so very much. Y'all have a good evening, and let me know if you need anything.